My name is Matthew McGirt. I'm a neurosurgeon practicing at Carolina Neurosurgery and Spine Associates, and I'm also the Vice Chief of Research and Outcomes at SpineFirst. Degenerative disc disease is really just as it sounds. It's one of the joints in the spine, usually the low back, which is really just worn out over time. It is dehydration and arthritis in the joint of the spine, which usually can become symptomatic in the form of back pain. You know, there are a couple of causes. Usually it's just wear and tear over time. You know, we've learned a tremendous amount about degenerative disc disease over the past decade. There is inflammation or inflammatory markers in these discs. And then a disc that usually serves as a shock absorber can just kind of become a little worn out and a little bit painful, usually over the years in the fourth, fifth, and sixth decades of life. The majority of degenerative disc disease, when it is symptomatic, is treated with non-surgical care. It's usually a multitude of physical therapies, oral medications, non-opioid or non-narcotic medicines, anti-inflammation medicines, coupled with physical therapy, are often the first line of treatment and effective in most cases. You know, usually if it goes undiagnosed or untreated, degenerative disc disease can progress and become worse. Many think that the earlier you jump on it, the earlier that you begin to treat it, whether it's physical therapy, whether sometimes it's an injection therapy or anti-inflammatory medicines, you can slow down the progression and cascading. So sometimes if it's ignored and it gets quite severe, it can be a little bit harder to improve. The number one symptom patients feel when they develop degenerative disc disease is pain. Now sometimes you might get an MRI or an x-ray and you'll see the radiologist reports there's degeneration of a disc, and sometimes it's not symptomatic. So we do see as a normal process in aging radiographically defined degenerative disc disease. But when it becomes painful, pro-inflammatory, collapsed or really non-mobile or arthritic, back pain is the number one symptom. But it can spread to the nearby nerves and cause some buttock or hip or sometimes radiating leg pain. We've been thinking about this and studying this for quite some time, and it's really hard to prevent per se. We do know general health is important. So maintaining a healthy body habitus or normal body weight can help prevent undue stress on the low back. We do know folks who put their bodies through a lot, folks who have hard labor jobs or do a lot of heavy lifting or sit a lot, can be prone to some increased stressors on the low back and can predispose. So really core strength, flexibility, eating well, and anti-inflammatory diets and behaviors can help minimize the chance of wear and tear on the back and degeneration. You know, it's really critical if a patient is told they have on a scan degeneration of a disc that they get into the care of an expert spine team. It's a niche area. There's some misconceptions. And so here at SpineFirst, CNSA, we have a multimodal team approach, right? We have physical therapists, we have surgeons, we have physiatrists who are medical experts at spine care, just so you don't end up chasing something that may not be the problem, because back pain is multifaceted. So you can have degeneration of a disc, but also have another pain generator. So it's important to figure out what's causing the back pain before you tailor a specific treatment. And so that's what's great about what we do here, is that we can begin to tease out, is it the degenerative disc that's a problem? Is it facet arthritis in the back of the spine? Or is it perhaps a pinched nerve? And so that's what's critical, is that you really come to a place like SpineFirst or a spine multidisciplinary center that can begin to get to the accurate pain generator. When physical therapies and oral medications aren't enough to help with degenerative disc disease related back pain, sometimes our physiatry care involving injections can be really helpful. It's a non-invasive, non-surgical approach where we can begin to denervate that painful disc without the need for surgery, that can really show effective improvement in back pain. And in the vast minority of cases, but occasionally surgery is required, and that's usually in the form of a fusion procedure. What's great about SpineFirst is that we have the full armamentarium and options of surgical techniques when needed. We keep it minimally invasive. We sometimes will come through the front to fuse that painful disc, or through minimally invasive and outpatient fusion procedures, can make very small incisions and fuse that painful joint from the back. But our goal is always to avoid the need for anything invasive through injection therapy, physical therapies, and oral therapies. Interestingly, degenerative disc disease can get better. There are a number of regenerative healthcare options that are now entering the market. We at SpineFirst, at Carolina Neurosurgery and Spine Associates, and Atrium Health follow this research and participate in this research actively. We know that with certain regenerative injections, some stem cell therapies, or even plasma-rich protein injections, we can begin to restore the normal physiology of a hydrated disc and a low inflammatory disc. So the field is really moving forward, and we are at the forefront of that. Degenerative disc disease is largely both a radiographic plus symptomatology diagnosis, because all degeneration on an MRI or X-ray is not painful. It really requires specialty to understand details or the nuances of the back pain really fit the characteristics of what we see on the MRI, or is it coming from another source? Pain from a painful disc is usually worse with bending forward or loading the front part of the spine. We also know that traction or pulling apart the spine can cause relief of those pain. And so these are sort of signs that the disc we see on imaging is painful. But to be clear, it is very pathognomonic, meaning it's very clear on MRI if a disc is degenerating or not. So radiographically, we have a very clear understanding and accurate diagnosis of what's going on inside. It is really important to see a specialist who has expertise in low back pain or really degenerative disc disease, because low back pain is complicated. 80% of Americans will seek care for significant back pain at some point in their life. And there's a multitude of pain generators: muscle, joints, nerves, degeneration of the disc. So it's really important to get in to see an expert team that can begin to understand and how to differentiate between those causes for your back pain.